welcome to the start of Super Sunday on NBC. Later on from New Orleans, it'll be the Bears and Patriots vying for number one in the NFL. But first, here at the Smith Center in Chapel Hill, 20-0 North Carolina looks to hold on to its number one ranking as they go up against the upside-minded Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. This game is brought to you by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world. By Light Beer from Miller, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. By the members of the first nationwide network for banking that's powerful and personal. And by the U.S. Army, a place to be all you can be. This is Marv Albert with Al McGuire coming up, North Carolina and Notre Dame. With a record of 12-2, ranked number 16 by the Associated Press, number 15 by UPI. A look at the starting lineup, and there are the Tar Heels of North Carolina, record of 20-0. If they could make it 21-0, it would equal the best start by a Dean Smith Tar Heel ball club here in North Carolina. And the Tar Heels in the white and blue have controlled the tip. Brent Dougherty, and this is Warren Martin, will pick up North Carolina as we go. Steve Hale, who comes off a poor shooting effort, at least for Hale yesterday. Captain on the save, but it's recaptured by Kenny Smith.
Good play by Kempton. You save a ball, you don't throw it towards your basket. You throw it towards the other basket.
And Dougherty. So Joe Wolf, who hit 10 of 11 yesterday against Georgia Tech for a career high of 22 points, gets going at the start.
From the top, Bob, I thought his knee was injured from yesterday banging into Hammonds, but it seems that he still has the stroke from yesterday.
This is Kempton, and this is the freshman, Mark Stevenson, going glass. And we're tied at two. Mark Stevenson, a freshman out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Again, as I said at the top of the show, watch the big men at North Carolina to be leg weary from playing yesterday.
And here's Dougherty. And rebounded by Stevenson. Stevenson and Rivers at the guards. Marlo Royal and Kempton up front. Here's David Rivers, the sophomore from Jersey City.
Dean Smith makes very few mistakes. He should have forced Notre Dame to play yesterday. Even they had to play against the Patsy. Notre Dame was waiting in the wings. Notre Dame likes to play a black and blue game. Don't have the talent of North Carolina, so they got the strength to match it.
Rivers with the step. Rebounded by Hale, and here come the Tar Heels. North Carolina had a similar weekend last week in terms of emotion. They opened the New Smith Center here against Duke on Saturday. There's a five-second violation. Beat the Blue Devils of Duke, then went to Marquette, had a very tough time, and came away with the squeak of victory on Sunday against Marquette.
And out of there with a white knuckler, but they were fortunate. Marquette played the day before against Dayton. So this is a no-no. Never let a team rest when you're playing.
No home, no home.
Donald Royal looking to get it back out. Here's Kempton. He had the baseline closed and forced the pass.
Excellent defense. And in comes the sixth man, which is the fans here at North Carolina.
Warren Martin. So Martin, who is playing despite recent bout with the virus, played well yesterday, another solid performance, and he is starting his fourth consecutive game here for the Tar Heels. Rivers.
Oh, great play. Acrobatics in the air. Both Dean Smith and Diegerfeldt are working the officials already.
That was on Steve Hale, his first team foul.
I got it. No. No, guys.
There's the call that Dean's upset about.
Got two.
The officials from the same conference.
All from the SEC. Wally Tanner, J. Don Ferguson, and Sonny Holmes. J. Don Ferguson, a man who you can relate to out of Savannah. And his full-time job in real life. He is an actor. He's done soaps. He's had some motion picture roles.
I think sometimes everyone in life is an actor.
Is that the Andy Warhol theory?
I like the other guy that takes care of lawns out there. What's his name, Taylor?
Wally Tanner.
Tanner.
Tied at four. And pass, Rivers ahead of the field. And Notre Dame up 6-4. And the crowd urging the Tar Heels on. Capacity crowd, as always here for the Tar Heels. 21,444.
Both teams are playing man-to-man. I look for later Notre Dame to go to the zone, especially if they get a lead. The key to Notre Dame's game here is Royal. He has to have a good ball game. Carolina is awesome.
And the foul against the Irish.
Watch Quicksilver here. Only a little guy, 6'1", but up and above, spikes it.
Ken Barlow committing that foul away from the ball. Dave Popson has come on, replacing Warren Martin. Popson, a junior out of Ashley, Pennsylvania. This is Hale. Wolf guarded by Royal. Hale shot only 3-for-12 yesterday against Georgia Tech. And Popson.
Round the horn again to reverse the ball.
Kenny Smith. Smith was 2-for-8 yesterday, but did a lot of other things, including getting the ball to the big man. He picked up 10 assists against Georgia Tech.
I said yesterday, and I say it again today, the only person that Carolina cannot afford to lose is Kenny Smith. He is probably will go down at North Carolina as the greatest point guard in their history.
Over Phil Ford.
Over Phil Ford. Phil was super. Phil was the one that made the four corners what it is.
Captain with a leaner for his first bucket.
Oh, he got himself a prayer there.
Notre Dame by two. Popson, and he's tied it at 8.
Popson has that low trajectory shot.
Dave Popson worked on his upper body strength during the offseason. He's actually gone from 210 to 225. He weighed 190 as a freshman. North Carolina looking to trap
at all times. When they trap, they overplay the post position, so you can't kick the ball in there. David Bibas has to keep the ball alive. That means don't kill your dribble.
Nice pass, and Barlow able to hammer home his first field goal. Bobby Grimmis of Georgia Tech was upset yesterday with the way his club handled the trap, blamed himself, but felt obviously that that cost him.
They were tentative. Surprisingly, I thought they would handle it better. Ooh, they're fighting for inside position. These refs are letting them play. There's a bounce pass. He had 2 points in his mind, but not in his hands. Barlow let the ball go through.
On the turnover, it comes back to the Tar Heels, but first, a timeout has been called. We'll be right back. Marv Albert with Al McGuire at the Dean Smith Student Activity Center on the campus of North Carolina in Chapel Hill. Dicker Phelps and his Notre Dame club paying a visit.
He has a game face on. It's a very important game for Dean, too. But more for Notre Dame.
Dean Smith inserting Kevin Madden, the 6'5 freshman, replacing Joe Wolf. Madden getting the playing time yesterday against Georgia Tech. Harris.
Rivers caught him, forced a wrist.
David Rivers committing his first.
No,
Diggy, you told him to put pressure up court. North Carolina expected it, and they broke it down. It's part of the game. Left-handed batter against a right-handed pitcher. What is that?
And here's Kenny Smith, 84% free throw shooter.
Almost automatic. Give him the kiss of death.
Fortunate you said almost. Out of Beloit High School in Queens. Last year against the Irish, Kenny Smith scored the game-winning basket, and then he intercepted the inbounds pass to Rapid. That was in the NCAA. Game played at Notre Dame. All-time series, North Carolina has beaten the Irish 10 out of 12.
type of game where Kempton, with his 265 pounds, could be a factor. See him keep the dribble alive? Now he's going to be calling the goal front here.
And he swept.
Right? Good call. That was a good call. But the trick is you must keep your dribble alive. Because when North Carolina puts that double pinch on you, if you kill your dribble, you're tap the city. It's a Dunkirk.
So North Carolina in possession off that travel by Rivers.
There's the grinding inside.
And a nice move by Kevin Madden. Kevin Madden, a freshman from Stark, Virginia, potentially explosive offensively. Carolina by one. 6.5 gone by.
He is the best athlete on the team. Out of New Orleans, if he gets a big game, Carolina could be in trouble.
Madden throwing it back out. And Notre Dame doing a nice job collapsing on Dougherty.
Watch Royal. Gets the baseline, goes in and slams it. About 6'5".
Substitutions, Tar Heels, sending back Joe Wolf. Jeff Lebo, the freshman from Carlisle, Pennsylvania, has come on for the first time. Hale and Thompson sit down. And the pressing defense, Stevenson. Mark Stevenson with a second field goal. He's played well. He had a little down period for a spell on the road. Going baseline.
Stevenson made that shot and was daydreaming. He didn't get back to play D. Carolina comes at you on offense like the throw. After the basket, they hit from him back down.
Here's Marlow. Captain on the board. Captain is rejected.
Nice move by Royal. He had to re-clutch that one. I think Dougherty was on him. Watch the first block by Wolf. Wolf puts it back in his face. Now here's Royal getting the ball. Dougherty, now watch him. See the clutch in there? He had a shoot on the way down. That is talent.
So Dougherty commits the foul, his first. Notre Dame with a one-point lead. And Donald Royal, 74% free throw shooter. He came on strong last season, showing much improvement.
This way off, Bob. I thought 6'5".
Get through the last minute or so.
No Billy Schmucks out there.
Watch him rolling, Brad. Watch him rolling, Brad.
And a 3-point. Notre Dame lead. 7 minutes gone by. Here's the trap.
Pay the price. I told you, Digga. They're waiting for that. Excellent. Well coached. North Carolina. Both teams well coached.
To a scrappy start.
Watch this pass, and over to the weak side. Once you put pressure on them up court, they space their men, and through they go to the basket.
Warren Martin is back. Brad Dougherty sitting down.
Over to the weak side. Rolls open.
Royal not able to hit.
Frustration, he hooked Jeff Lebo.
Third team foul committed by Notre Dame.
The rhythm is what Notre Dame wants. They don't want a racehorse style where North Carolina's bench gets involved. Digga has a rotation of about 7, where North Carolina has a rotation of 10 ball players. Looking to go backdoor. Beautiful man movement, man ball movement over to the weak side. Reverse the ball. Now kick it inside to Mont or Wolf, one or the other.
Out of 15 on the 45-second clock, here's Wolf.
constant man-to-man. The refs could blow the whistle every time. This style of basketball is impossible to referee because you could blow it every time down. Basketball is a contact sport. People think it isn't. It's absolutely contact, Mom. Answer me, Mom.
And the ball goes back the other way, and we'll take a break. A timeout, 11:17 remaining, first half. Apparently, Digger Phelps did not like that last turnover call, the traveling against the Irish. Digger has been at his best in pulling off the upset. Check out this list. Notre Dame's best known upset of a number one team 12 years ago. They knocked off UCLA, ended the Bruins' 88-game win streak. How about the one back in 78, beating your Marquette club 65-59? You've won, what, 81 straight at home?
81 straight at home. In my confessional box, they come in, the Iceman Clay hit it from the corner, and he blocked me.
So Notre Dame here at North Carolina looking to put a dent into that 20-0 record of the Tar Heels that come in ranked number one. Steve Hale and Curtis Hunter now, sent in by Dean Smith.
Remember now, the baseline of Carolina will be leg weary. Big men cannot recover, especially young big men. They're not broke. They don't have the spring in their legs they had yesterday.
That's Hunter with the ball, watched by Barlow. Lebo and Hale at the guard, so Hunter up front with Martin and Wolf.
Playing a sloughing off man-to-man.
Lebo had it knocked away by Rivers. Carolina by one, 17-16. As we approach the halfway point of this first half.
Bumping and grinding down low.
It's an offensive foul, the charge on Barlow, his second foul.
Dolan put a body on Barlow's man, which allowed it. Dutch Rivers hit Barlow coming off a pick. Barlow commits too soon to the air. Obvious charge.
14th foul for the Irish.
Sloughing off zone. Weak side's open. Watch him get it around to Hale. Royals trying to cheat on the weak side over there. See him cheating? Get it around to Hale.
And again is Wolf, his third field goal. So he has hit 13 out of 14, going back to yesterday's performance against Georgia Tech.
Notre Dame's trying to stop the putback, the garbage basket. That's when Carolina kills him. Hale got his work cut out today trying to stop Rivers. So quick.
And the foul on North Carolina. Here's Kenny Smith back. Lebo sits down. And Brad Dougherty returns.
Again, with the four big men, they shotgun the foul. What I mean by that, Hobson, Dougherty, Mott, Wolf. If you check on their statistics, with all the games played, they all got about 60 or 70 fouls on first foul. They call that shotgun.
Able to spread it out. Hale just picked up that last foul. Nice move by Jim Dolan, who just checked in.
Handle the pressure into the corner. You cannot run an offense out of the corner.
Pretty pass, and Wolf was hammered by Dolan. Joe Wolf will go to the line. Dolan picks up his first.
Dolan's more of a blue-collar player. Doesn't have a lot of speed. Plays intelligent inside the foul line. He's out there really today as a push and shover. All they want, Digger wants out there is bodies. Utilize bodies in North Carolina.
Two shots.
And spread the fouls out. He wants Kempton in good shape that second half.
Joe Wolf, 68% free throw shooter, and off to a fast start once again. Joe Wolf, who says his favorite movie is Never Cry Wolf.
Cola, Wisconsin. That's where they make all the plumbing things. It's right next to Sheboygan. And I flew down here 2 days ago with his parents on the plane.
They make the plumbing things, huh?
Whatever they are, plumber. Watch this. He doesn't kill his dribble. Keep your dribble alive, son. See that? Hey, keep it alive. I told you. Now feed off. That's it. Unbelievable. That is a star. An absolute star.
Wolf committing the foul, so Barlow will go to the line.
No use me talking over this free play. Just watch. This brings tears into the eyes of the Globetrotters.
David Rivers, who had a 17-point game against North Carolina last year.
He committed the boo-boo at the end, turned the ball over to the NCAA, turned it over, and Kenny Smith, I think, went down and made the basket. That was the end of the season for Notre Dame.
Barlow has 4 points, and Notre Dame trailing by one, 21-20.
All right, move the ball around, kick it inside.
Dolan on the steal.
Dribble back out, set up. Smith keep a lot of pressure on him.
Rivers doing it between the legs, and that hits. Notre Dame by one, 22-21. Here's Hunter.
Yes, big shot. And Carolina's so good.
He's been hitting 61% from the floor. Curtis Hunter, a junior from Durham, North Carolina. Tar Heels by one.
Notre Dame cannot play any better. That was a walk.
Traveled on Rivers.
He gave a head and shoulder fake and moved both feet.
Substitution, Joseph Price, who had been going great guns for a while, replaces Ken Barlow. Last two, three games, he's been off the mark.
Joseph Price, first chance he gets, will pop from the outside. 1-3-1 zone. Spread it out.
Wolf again inside.
I said yesterday Wolf was the best ball player out of Wisconsin in the last decade. He might be the best player ever out of Wisconsin. I'm sorry, Jimmy Jones.
3-point Carolina lead. Scott Hicks in trouble. Able to get away with throwing it out. Price on the save. Down to 8 minutes left, first half.
Got to get the ball in Rivers' hands. There it is. Now something happens. Watch.
Crowd on its feet now. 10 on the shot clock. Here's Rivers. And it's North Carolina's possession. On the tie-up. Official timeout here in Chapel Hill, 7:43 remaining. First half, North Carolina by 3 points. Marv Albert, Dick McGuire, good. Al McGuire, fine. Dick will be here later, Al.
Well, I hope my brother Dick gets in the Hall of Fame. He deserves to be in it. He's a great player in his day, and he's, a matter of fact, he's a better person than he even was a player.
Which is a nice compliment, because he was one of the great setup men, one of the great assist men.
No, Mark, if anyone says anything wrong about my brother Dick, there's something wrong with them.
I was about to say, upcoming the Super Bowl here on NBC, Dick Enberg will be at the microphone and will be taking a close-up look at Dick. I know he spent some time with him out of his California home several months ago. That'll be our halftime feature.
I think you'll enjoy the feature at halftime. We have his beautiful wife, Barbara, on, and his daughter, Nicole. So stay around and forget about flush time.
That's later on. That's during the Super Bowl in a special minute presentation. Jeff Lebo back on the floor along with Dave Thompson for North Carolina. Tar Heels by three, 25-22, 7:20 left in this first half. Here's Thompson off the screen. The second field goal. And North Carolina has its biggest lead. They lead by five.
One of you's going to leave the game. Don't let it happen.
Now, forget it, because ref, you cannot stop it. These two teams are too physical and too big. They're space eaters. It's impossible to referee this game by the rules. You've got to let the pushing and shoving go.
Well, Dougherty, Kempton, and Dolan were all involved, having some words.
Unless we want a foul shoot contest, because they're picking down. Both teams are picking down, putting their bodies on people.
Here's Price. And rebounded by Hicks. Nice fake. And Hicks stepped out.
We're going to our first breakout level. If North Carolina gets the 7 points, that's the first breakout level. It's 7-11, 14 and out. So they got a 5-point lead now. Watch the picking and shoving underneath. There's Lebo laying on Kemp. There's Hale and Price going out. There's a back door.
And they turn it over on the back door attempt.
Get it back to the PT boat. Round to the PT boat. Get it over to the rim.
Price fires. And rebounded by Lebo.
Beautiful pass by Kenny Smith that time.
Smith, too strong. Here's Hicks.
He's going no matter what. He made up his mind about 10 feet in front.
And it's a block on Lebo.
Well, we got to watch this one. The ref was right on top of it. But Hicks made up his mind. He was going no matter what. I think maybe Lebo, by picking up his arms, created the movement. See him pick up his arms then? Yep, good call by the ref.
And that'll put Scott Hicks on the line. Mark Stevenson back, replacing Joseph Price. Hicks, a junior from Indianapolis. Excellent leaper, as we saw in that last sequence. And an excellent foul shooter, 81%. Notre Dame comes in at 12-2. Last Saturday here on NBC, they knocked off UCLA at home. During the week, a soft part of the schedule. Victories over Hofstra and American University.
Well, two real heavyweights.
Now, let's not get cynical. Let's check out the Marquette schedule from several years ago.
Leave me alone. Let's put this thing in here. They're just pushing and shoving, knocking each other over.
Just under six remaining.
Oh, there's an elbow. Dolan took it on purpose. He was annoying Popson, and Popson cleared him out with an elbow. Didn't affect Dolan. I knew these coaches would be up. Digger and period. Watch this elbow. Dolan pushes his belly in there. See that belly? Kind of nudges him. One of those sumo wrestlers. Now watch Popson. Oh, we missed him. Popson cleaned him out with an elbow.
And Dolan smiled it off as if to say, well, we kind of baited you into that one.
Well, as I said earlier, blue collar. Again, down below, they need bodies.
Joe Wolf is back. He's up front with Dougherty.
Got to remember, inside the paint, North Carolina got 20 fouls to give. The average team might have 10 or maybe 8 to give.
Tar Heels back to a three-guard offense. Scott Hicks, yes. 27-26, so the Irish back to within one.
Went back to man-to-man. Dougherty got position on Kempton. Just watch that grinding underneath. That's the game. Look at it underneath. 8 guys bump. Every time they go by, they get the shoulder pads out. Get the helmets out. But forget the Super Bowl. We got it here. Wolf is back into Dolan. They'll get into Wolf this time. Nope. Oh, he's calling on George. Hey, they can call either way. Wolf is pushing, Dolan's pushing. What happens here is the two refs, coaches that will work. Tigger Phelps will be working, and so will Dean Smith. Here it is here. Watch Dolan leading on him. There's another pick right there. Now watch the pick come around. If there's a call on Dolan, please come back.
Well, how do you handle a game like this? What do you do?
Well, either you ruin the game and make a foul shot, or you let them play. I think the refs are doing a good job.
Well, if you let them play, there's going to be a fight.
Oh, I don't know if there'll be a fight.
Which you don't mind.
Well, no one ever. I never seen an athlete get hurt in a fight. The spectators have to do it. And the faculty don't like it. The president of the university don't like it. So they like to have meetings for meeting's sake.
The aggressive Al McGuire.
A fair fight never hurt anybody. Here we are. We're back in the meat grinder again underneath.
Lebo, nice pass.
Beautiful play. Give one of those points to Kenny Smith and the other one to Jeff Lebo.
29-26. North Carolina by three. Rivers moving on Smith. Kevin Madden back in for North Carolina. He's on Dolan. Bad pass. Stopped by Rivers. What a foul. Second foul for David Rivers.
Very quick hand. And now Now it's a foot race. Kenny Smith has beat him, but Kenny happens to be dribbling the ball, which slows him down a little. An obvious two-shot foul. Digger had to get the freshman out, Stevenson. Stevenson's a little bit nervous. He shot at the top, but he was hesitant when he came back in the second
shot.
He's a good ball player, but he's only a freshman playing in front of 23,000 people.
That includes those who snuck in.
15, Donald Royal.
Donald Royal.
For Jim Dolan.
Back replacing Jim Dolan. Notre Dame at 1 point at 1-7 in a row before losing at Brigham Young in overtime 2 weeks ago. Good road trip, though. They won 3 of 4, winning at LaSalle, Providence, and DePaul. Record of 12-2. The Tar Heels, ranked number one in the nation. They are 20-0 coming off yesterday afternoon's victory here over highly ranked Georgia Tech.
No embarrassment losing to BYU at Provo, Utah. Very difficult. Close to a 5-count.
4:15 left, first half. Kenny Barlow with his second field goal. He has 6, 30-28, North Carolina by 2.
That's Barlow's spot. He won't any place along the baseline. Him and Joe Wolf will bottom it out from there. Again, here comes the grinding underneath start with the four men. Then the big men will move in. Here comes Wolf down. Now watch Doherty pass. But down low, Doherty. Now you and Wolf. Oh, what a pick. Holy mackerel. Did you see that?
And it brought Al off his seat.
They just run into each other.
And the foul called.
They're in a one-on-one. It has to be a one-on-one shot. What do you think?
North Carolina.
Then comes another big guy. Martin comes in. Wolf goes out. Dean Smith again is shotgun his foul.
Well, Wolf just picked up his second.
Doesn't make any difference. He could be his fourth. They got so many guys to alternate the fouls. I don't know if the people understand, Mom, what we're talking about with shotgun. You spread the foul, and you try to get the other center in foul trouble because you don't have the length of the bench.
To this point, Kempton does not have a foul. And Royal able to take advantage of the one-on-one. Brett Dougherty's been very quiet, 10 for 17 yesterday.
He'll come. His statistics are unbelievable. He's a true All-American. If the draft was tomorrow, he would probably be number one.
So we're tied at 30. 3:49 remaining in this first half. A timeout was called, but North Carolina had made its move up court.
Well, North Carolina is so quick getting into their offense that they missed the commercial timeout, and now both teams are straight.
And now the timeout is being called. We'll be back here in Capitol Hill in a moment. Well, at Carmichael, North Carolina was able to win almost 90% of its games. And here at Dean's Dome in the new Smith Center, they're looking to make it 3-0. They knocked off Duke in the opener last Saturday. Yesterday afternoon, the victory over Georgia Tech.
At the Dome, defeat may be unknown.
Very nice. Can I write that down?
You can put it in the bank.
3 minutes, 49 seconds remaining in this first half. And North Carolina and Notre Dame are tied at 30.
Looks like Notre Dame's going to slip into a zone as Carolina penetrates. Let's see. It is a zone now, 2-3. Oh, the actor caught the actor. Our referee that... Doherty went up to get an Emmy, but he didn't realize he had an actor underneath him, the referee.
That's J. Don Ferguson out of the SEC, who in real life is an actor. Does TV soaps, several motion pictures. Here's Rivers. Hits on the tip, will not count. Offensive interference.
Boy, can Hicks get upstairs. No problem on this. Watch Hicks climb. Did interfere. The ball was still inside the cylinder. They're going to try to get the ball into Doherty if possible. Get him off the side.
Here it is. Good up.
In a battle with Kempton. And that's his first bucket.
I figured that they had to get him into the flow of the game. It was time.
He is second in the nation in field goal percentage with 66% from the floor. Brad Ballard, 2 points. North Carolina lead. Here is Barlow. That's his favorite spot.
Can't let him shoot from there. He's another postage stamp shooter like Wolf is. Digger is up there cheerleading. Give him the ball, Digger. Get off, Hamill. Look at Digger pass. Yeah, oh, boy. Oh, he'd break up a high mass.
Tied at 32. 2.5 left in this first half. Notre Dame has done it off the boards. They have out-rebounded North Carolina. They have been very strong off the boards this season.
Notre Dame's giving them the weak side shot against that pocket zone.
Tim Kempton, too strong. And rebounded by Dougherty.
Tim shoots straight ahead on from the corner.
Smith off the hesitation. And a 2-point North Carolina lead.
Big basket.
Under two left, first half. Rivers and a blocking foul on the Tar Heels, Warren Martin.
That was a church league call. Feather touch. That really wasn't a foul.
And it's a one-on-one situation. Tim Kempton, 68% from the line. We saw Tim have one of his better games offensively last week against UCLA. 20-point effort.
Well, with Martin covering him, Kempton being 265 pounds, like two elephants, so I guess the refs want to keep apart. He's a fellow that doesn't have great statistics, but he'll go in the NBA, he'll be a backup center, last 10 years, and be a millionaire.
Can I have the rights to the screenplay? Tied at 34, and at 45 remaining, first half. Nice pass for Dougherty. Yes, and it counts. The foul on Kempton.
Great shot. New baby hook. Tim Kempton, instead of going up with one arm, went up with both arms, which you can't get high enough that way. Not against this guy. He's 7 feet.
Brad Dougherty looking for the three-point play, a 69% free throw shooter.
That was the most important 3 points of this game. You could end up putting Carolina in maybe 5-6 up. Notre Dame got the score this time down psychologically.
It's been close throughout. North Carolina has led by as many as five. They have that three-point lead. Here's the pressure defense by the Tar Heels. Rivers had nowhere to go.
Yeah, but he didn't panic. That's the key. 20 seconds on the clock. The crowd's starting to annoy Notre Dame.
Nice pass.
There's a walk. No basket. High.
Well, the coach making the call.
Yeah, it was a walk. Man was free in the left. Nice pass by Tim. Took a walk on the boardwalk in Atlantic City.
And a minute 10 remaining in this first half. North Carolina in possession with a three-point lead.
Mark down that three-point play by Dougherty. It might be the turning point of the game.
Blocking foul called, illegal pick against North Carolina.
They'll shoot on him, I believe.
Warren Martin called for his second. And here's Dave Thompson checking back. Martin will depart. Two apiece on Martin, Wolf, and Hale. And it is one and one.
Darryl's favorite is Notre Dame. Both teams are in a one and one. Got 102 left. 3-point spread. And the best athlete, my opinion, on the team is on the line.
Four out of four from the line. And he's called for the travel.
Good call. He did move his feet.
under a minute to go, first half.
There goes the kite flying out underneath.
Little contact there.
29 seconds on the shot clock. Notre Dame will play for one shot and they get the ball. That should be two. Leibold.
Jeff Leibold with a second field goal. 5-point lead. We are down to 30 seconds remaining. First half.
They should take it out. They have to go in five and possibly three. Here comes the pressure. Trying to get the ball out of Rivers' hands. Oh, stop it. It was a good call. Good call. You're bumping and grinding on that two-man pressure. You know you are.
And Lebo picked up the foul. 22 seconds left.
Hey, Bob, I got two calls last night. I don't care who wins basketball games. As an announcer, all I want is close games.
You mean someone accused you of rooting?
Yesterday, they called, last night, two calls, and I locked my phone. They said, why did you say Georgia Tech has a better starting five than North Carolina? I said, because I believe they got a better starting five.
That was my call. You didn't recognize the voice.
Oh, okay. I don't care who wins the ball game. I just want a close game. Close game, we keep an audience.
Five substitution, Jim Dolan back. There he is. Ken Barlow sits down. It's all point of view, obviously.
Well, thank God my mother has money. I don't have to worry about it.
22 seconds remaining in this first half. And it will be Notre Dame ball.
They'll take it down, listen to foul. Take it down for one shot. They can possibly get in two down.
A good foul situation. 16 left.
It's a strong move and has brought the Irish within two. You see the clock running down. Here's Lebo. Smith nearly hit at the buzzer. So we have a two-point game at halftime. Here in Chapel Hill, it's North Carolina 39 and Notre Dame 37. We'll be back in just a moment. Back at the Dean Smith Student Activity Center on the campus of North Carolina Chapel Hill, a look at the halftime statistics. North Carolina leading Notre Dame by the score of 39-37.
The only thing that jumps out at me is the free throws. Notre Dame making 13 out of 15. Normally the team that's taller gets more foul shots, and obviously North Carolina is taller. The other thing on the turnovers, surprisingly last year, Marv, North Carolina led the ACC in turnovers.
And a look at the individual scoring totals. Ken Barlow with three field goals, two foul shots, 8 points in all. David Rivers with seven. And six apiece for Kempton and Royal. Joe Wolf having another terrific start. He was 10 of 11, 22 points career high yesterday against Georgia Tech. He's hit four of four and leads the way.
I think maybe Brad Daugherty is showing effects from the game yesterday against Georgia Tech. That was an up-and-down game, and I think he played about 32 minutes.
And here's what we were discussing earlier, the foul spread, or as you put it, shotgunning the fouls.
You alternate them. See what happened? They're the four red trees that North Carolina uses. What? That's what they did up to this game. He'll alternate the fouls between his four big men, but he'll take your center out of the game foul-wise. Referees don't blow one way, they blow both ways.
We're set for the start of play of the second half. North Carolina by two. We've had 20 changes of the lead. North Carolina has led by as many as five. Notre Dame led just briefly at the start, and they had a one-point lead midway through the first half. Notre Dame ball as we pick it up in the second half, and here's Barlow getting right through it. We're tied at 39.
He's the best shooter at Notre Dame, but you still get that feeling that Hale's going to come out of the drought and that North Carolina's going to have that run. And all they need is a run of about 45 seconds to blow you out of here. Hale. Notre Dame starts in the zone.
Hale did not take a shot of the first half. Kenny Smith putting North Carolina up by two. Hale went 3 for 12 yesterday against Georgia Tech.
Well, he gives so much defensively. I think if Notre Dame's going to play a zone, it should be a 1-3-1, which protects the point. That's why Kenny Smith just hit the shot.
Basket will not count. The foul before the shot attempt called on Kenny Smith, his first.
Southpaw. He's taken Notre Dame from Clydesdale to Fort Lyons.
And it is Fingerfelt's best team in some 5 years. David Rivers has forced Rivers to change his style. That's an offensive foul. Rivers has picked up his third.
Wow, I think the second half, what I can see now, we're only in 50 seconds, that they're going to change the whistle. I think we're going to go to the high school whistle. That was a quick whistle that time. So let's see if we get a fast whistle and a no contact second half. I hope not, because our first half was excellent.
Smith and Hale at the guards. Martin, Dougherty, and Wolf up front. Here's Dougherty.
Once the Tar Heels start putting the ball back in those kidneys, you're in trouble.
Here we go. Ready? Play.
Smith for Martin.
Starting to play with the hands up in the air. And float the ball over.
And Martin does have the tremendous reach. North Carolina by 4, 43-39. Rivers. Way off. And rebounded by Wolf. Now met by Hicks, who is starting the second half.
That's a charge. Got away, Wolf.
Scott Hicks starting instead of a freshman, Mark Stevenson. Rivers and Hicks at the guards. Marlowe, Royal, and Captain up front. Marlowe around Wolf.
Eight men inside the foul line on both teams. Grinding's going to start again, just bumping each other. Here's the triangle of the three big men.
Wolf is 5 for 5 from the floor, 10 for 11 yesterday.
Now watch this time down. The four Notre Dame ball players will go inside the paint and start swinging on the baseline, taking for one another. Here comes the trap, they'll get it over to the weak side. Three in the weak side.
Royal able to keep it alive. Barlow again. So Ken Barlow has 14 and Notre Dame down by 2.
Dean, you got to call off that two-man trap. They got it broke. Just like you got Notre Dame's pressure up court broke.
Smith from deep.
You can't let anybody shoot head on. That's the easiest shot outside of a layup is from the top of the key head on. Piece of cake.
10 points for Smith. And he's had the hot hand. He's 4 out of 5 from the floor. 4-point Tar Heel lead. Marlow. Rebound. Hicks and a foul.
Foul on guard. Let the first 2 fouls go by to call the third.
Dave Popson comes back. Mark Martin sits down.
Take him right back up.
That should have been
Box Corner Barlow. Scotty, right here. Scotty Lowe. Box Corner Barlow.
You want to get the ball to Barlow? They say no pick. Watch him keep the dribble alive. The system. Only he can lift the ball. The dribble stays alive. Back over to the weak side for an easy pop. When they're scrambling, putting 2-3 men at you, the ball is always 3 on the weak side. There'll be a man waiting there for it. Now North Carolina goes to one of their rare zones. The 2-3 that will develop into a trap, I believe, once it goes into the corner. Barlow clears out. Here comes the trap. Now around the Barlow. I should let that fly, son. North Carolina, so good. Mr. H.C.
he's got that. But here, Mr. H.C. will have it. Let's see. Let's see. I don't think it did hit the end line. Let's take a look at it. Here we go. He got it.
Mr. Harry. The head in the way.
Harry Curl got it. It didn't touch the line. I thought he was going to call a walk because he's turning over. Only at NBC do you get shots like that.
4 minutes gone by in the second half. And Notre Dame trailing North Carolina by 4. Rivers bringing it back out.
Nice D on Popson that time.
Rivers, yes.
Top of the key, automatic, for any decent guard in the country.
9 points for Rivers. And the Tar Heels by 2. Dougherty. Walk. Will not count. It's a travel.
That was a tight call. The ref was right on top of it. But these two guys are just leaning on one another. 265 pounds leaning on you creates a problem.
And a timeout call. North Carolina leading by 2. We'll be right back. Well, last week you made an appearance on CBS, Al, at the Marquette, North Carolina game. We provide equal time.
Well, there's Mothball Head. When he drives into a gas station, the bell doesn't go off.
And he's a good friend of yours.
Very close. He's a very talented man. He knows basketball, I feel it.
4.5 gone by in the second half. And North Carolina by 2, 47-45.
And remember, Notre Dame did not play yesterday. Very, very serious error, I think, on the part of North Carolina. Not making them play a game.
In effect, insisting, if they are to meet here, that they also have to play, and that North Carolina plays Georgia Tech.
Especially their big men are a little leg weary. Time left, 20 seconds, 45 seconds, a lifetime. Keeping that dribble alive.
Just kept it. Forced the shot. Pops it off the ball. And the foul, basketball knocked out.
I think the foul was on Royal.
Substitutions, Warren Mark. Dave Popson, Jim Dolan is back. And Ronald Royal commits the foul. Kempton sitting down. Donald Royal with his second.
I wonder if Deacon thought that foul was on Tim Kempton and made a quick move.
Both teams with
5 count. 5 count. He's going to touch the ball by 5. Good play.
Just got it in, but it's turned over. And Rivers on a breakaway. Right down.
The quickest guard bringing the ball down the court in my 9 years of doing television. Great. That should be due. He was due.
His first field goal attempt.
Yeah, he was due. He's too good of a ball player to not be heard from.
Steve Hale with his first bucket and the Tar Heels by 2.
Dolan's just on Martin's covering him. Dolan's not going to shoot.
Rivers does. And Hicks gets it back. Here is Barlow. Dowdy, able to recapture.
Set up. Try to get the ball in the Dougherty again. Here it is.
And the foul on Dolan backing in to Dougherty.
I would say he did back in. Knocked him out. Stone's expendable.
Lebo back. Martin sitting down. Smith, Hale, and Lebo now in a three-guard alignment with Wolf and Dowdy. Wolf wide open.
That's what you get for playing man-to-man against the ball being taken out of bounds on your own baseline.
Wolf 6 for 6.
Beautiful timeout by Digger. Outstanding call.
13:23 left in the game, and North Carolina by 4. 1,444 capacity crowd on the new Dean Smith Student Activity Center. Third game played here. They opened up last week with North Carolina Duke. Yesterday, the North Carolina Georgia Tech game. $34 million raised entirely through private funds. In fact, those who contributed $250,000 to the building were given the prime seats for life.
Well, the front seats by us, that a donation of $250,000, they could buy, I think, 6 to 8 seats. It's $11 a ticket. That doesn't give them free tickets. They still got to buy them.
North Carolina by 4. Notre Dame in possession.
Always after a timeout, Dean will come up with something different.
Royal off the back door to bring the Irish with him, too.
He got away with a walk there. Irish are in the zone now, 1-2-2. Trying to save Tim Kempton. Now they go to a man-to-man. No, they're staying in the zone. It's Raven Smith wherever he goes. It's like a box one. That's right, Griffin's on him.
'53-49. Number one ranked Tar Heels of North Carolina by 4. Rivers on a pull up and a foul. John Smith.
Watch Royals. I think he took steps here. 1, baby. 2, baby. 3, baby. Holy mackerel. He used to play that game in the Bronx years ago. May I take 3 steps? Yes, you may.
And Donald Royal. Able to hit on a second field goal. That's 8 points in all.
Got to get the ball to follow down in the corner to bottom it out. 2-3 zone. Now the trap will come when he passes the ball.
Here's Stevenson.
Ooh, that's a big basket by a freshman coming in. He was just on the bench for 8 minutes, 9 minutes. You'd think he'd wait for the sweat to come.
Stevenson right off the bench to hit his third field goal. Scott Hicks starting the second half. So Notre Dame hanging around. Down by 2, 53-51.
Carolina's still looking for that one big run. Just destroyed. They're already moving back down low now inside that zone. They look to alley-oop over the zone if they possibly can. Got to be honest with Lebo. Lay off Smith on the angle, not the flat out.
And they turn it over. Wolf had too much oddity. Try to go cross court.
That's very rare you see a Carolina team throw a ball away like that. Very rare.
And Notre Dame with an opportunity to tie it.
Here's the kid that's keeping the game going, keeping the ball alive. Clock in his head, shows no emotion.
David Rivers has tied it at 53.
Imagine how proud his parents and his friends are.
Rivers playing, though, with 3 personal fouls. He now has 11. Kenny Smith.
Kenny, you're outstanding. Absolutely outstanding. So is our producer, Kenny Edwards.
A 2-point North Carolina lead, 55-53. Smith got a piece of it.
Wolf going out for a blow. In comes Mott. 6'10" moves out, 7 foot moves in.
And Wolf departs with 14. He's hit all 6 field goal attempts, so he is 16 for his last 17.
He's a tired young guy. See that knee pad? He banged knees yesterday with Hammond, Georgia Tech. After timeout, in the zone, there'll be some type of attacking when the ball goes to the corner.
Freshman Kevin Madden back in now. Lemo sitting down. 10.5 remaining. 55-53. North Carolina leading by 2.
Around the ball, though.
Rivers from deep. And the foul on North Carolina.
a two-man press. Here it comes. Here comes the big guy out there already. There goes the PT vote.
Great ball for the Tar Heels. Last touch by Stevenson of Notre Dame.
That 2.5 hours last night, that thing worked right in this place here. Paid off. Less than 10 minutes.
He was stepped. He was on the baseline. And the Irish will take over.
Doherty seems quite tired. So does Martin. I said at the top of the show, and I know I'm repeating myself, a big mistake in not making Notre Dame play yesterday.
And North Carolina now has turned it over five times in the second half. Notre Dame only once.
Dolan, get the ball to Rivers.
And here comes Smith whipping it down. Hell! And Barlow on the rebound.
Doherty just does not seem to have the strength. Obviously the strength that he had yesterday. Watch the eight guys underneath the basket. That's 2 points.
Barlow.
Shots, I believe, and the ball out. I don't think it was a breakaway, but let's see if they do call. Let's see. It wasn't a breakaway, so I don't know how they can call it that way, but they might. Let's see. Now, it's a new rule put in this year, but he wasn't breaking away. Maybe they'll just give him the two shots. When he heard the whistle, he had continuity and threw the ball up. But he put it up almost a second after the whistle.
Apparently they're calling it a two-shot foul. No breakaway. 9 minutes remaining of the game. Yeah. 13 points for Kenny Smith. And here's Lebo back. Madden sits down. An 84% foul shooter. He's 3 out of 5 from the line.
Rivers has 4 fouls. He cannot take time. Don't allow him in there, because without him, it's tap city.
North Carolina by 4, 57, 53.
He'll probably force Notre Dame into the zone to protect Rivers from the foul. If he picks up his fifth, it'll probably be in the charge.
Here's Barlow with room. He's missed his last several. Foul committed by Hale of North Carolina.
That was a foul for execution, for effort. That's Hale's fourth foul.
And the 15th foul for the Tar Heels. Notre Dame has 4. Hale will sit down. Madden returns. 14 deals. Substitutions are statistician Rod Kreideman has North Carolina's Dean Smith making his 22nd substitution of the day. Digger Phelps with only 9.
23rd will be coming in with Wolf right now. He'll probably take Doherty out.
Royal lost it. Throws one high and far. Got away. Here comes Joe Wolf.
Surprisingly, he took Martin out. I thought they'd take Doherty out.
And now Barlow sits down. Joseph Price makes his return. Digger hoping for the hot hand from Price.
Price can hit from the outside. Barlow had 2 open shots that didn't drop.
Barlow leads with 14. He's pulled off. Had the good start.
Remember this young man, he has 4 fouls. I say if he picks up his fifth, he'll be charged with the ball.
This is Price with it. Royal to the foul.
Now he stepped in. Charge, called it a charge. I probably in on that. I think it was Lebo. Here it is. Let's see. Yep.
And that is foul number three committed by Donald Royal. 7:54 remaining in the game. And North Carolina leads by 4. Well, both yesterday and today with a number of pro prospects on Georgia Tech and Notre Dame and North Carolina, a host of NBA executives, officials, scouts on hand. There's Bob Ferry, general manager of the Washington Bullets.
His son played for Duke. He probably caught that game. There's been 16 scouts here today watching the players. Obviously, there's so many bodies, which the most important thing in pro ball is your body.
Marty Blake, head of the NBA scouting system here. Jerry West, Gene Tremolin of the Lakers. Rick Buccolo of the Knicks.
Don't forget my man, Wayne Embry.
Wide Wayne, now with the Indiana Pacers. Hello, Clippers, represented by Brad Greenberg. Ed Badger of the Celtics. Larry Strauss of the Bulls, all on hand. 7:45 remaining of the game. North Carolina leading by 4. That was meant to be an alley-oop. Rivers able to thread it, but Stevenson could not hit. And here comes Kenny Smith of the Tar Heels.
I believe it'd be their biggest lead if he hits this.
North Carolina has led by as many as 5. And it will be Notre Dame ball. Last touch by the Tar Heels. Scott Hicks makes his return. Here's another look.
Dean did not react because the ball was tapped at the very end by Daugherty. Now, the ref hesitates a second, get his colors straight. That's the way the Indians went.
And the Irish take over. Rivers playing with the 4 fouls. Looking for Price in front of by Madden. Hicks off the screen. Rebound down. Here's Madden.
He's upset with himself.
6 for 7 today. 10 for 11 yesterday.
Seems like North Carolina's waiting for Notre Dame to make a move.
Rivers. Beaver club able to hit.
The numbers are right. Go all the way.
And Kempton commences second.
Now there's a college education for you. Let's improve the academics.
Those are not the NBA scouts that we referred to earlier.
Oh, they're overdressed for NBA scouts.
You're tough.
Oh, the Super Bowl. Oh, they're waiting down there. The guys got those butterflies. Is this going to be the biggest audience ever?
I think it has a shot because of all the publicity involving Chicago Bears. Jim McMahon certainly getting wider exposure than anyone. Back to the Joe Namath 1969 New York Jet upset of the Baltimore Colts. Much more media exposure this week. They have a shot if the game stays close. And North Carolina now has its biggest lead, a 6-point margin. Kenny Smith with 16 points, and he is the high man for North Carolina.
Can't understand that move. It won't be long. Digger took out David. Maybe to just give him a blow, but it's a dangerous move. Watch out for turnover now. See how Hicks handles the ball. They got Price in there to shoot from the outside.
Dolan really shoots and is called for a travel.
That was good ball movement. I thought the shot should have been taken by Price. Look alive, Notre Dame. They come right at you, Carolina. Lebo three in the corner. Looks like they're trying to kick the ball into the trees this time. Here it is.
Warren Martin.
You better get a timeout and get your man back in there. You've got to have Rivers in there.
And Digger Phelps upset. That is a Digger Phelps coaching conference along with Gary Brokaw. to his right, one-time All-American at Notre Dame, the other assistants, Jim Barron, Matt Kilcullen.
What they're doing, they try to eliminate indecision. Then Diggle will go back to the huddle, and you say to his ball players, give me your eyes. You got a ball player's eyes, you got your ears. And then he'll tell them what he wants done. Then he'll have the ref break his huddle. And as the ref comes to break his huddle, he'll mention something he wants to plant in the ref's mind. He's saying, hey, you're letting Doherty get away with walking. But he'll be saying it to his team. That's a tip from the top.
Yes, an Al McGuire tip from the master of planting innuendos in the minds of the officials. So an 8-point lead for North Carolina, their biggest lead of the game. A run of 8 consecutive points for the Tar Heels has done it. Kempton from outside. And rebounded by Leibold.
It's going to kick in low. They want to get it to Doherty. Whoop will go down low now. Now the body grinding will start.
Steve Hale is back playing with the 4 fouls. They go 3 guards, Lebo, Hale, and Smith.
Dean doesn't have the obvious break. He'll take about 25 seconds off the clock and 30 seconds each time down. We call that milking. You go from milking to a delay to a freeze. A freeze is when you don't take any shots. That means the game is over. If you shoot, the coach punches you. No.
And down to 8 on the 45-second clock. Here's Smith. Under 5 left in the game.
The difference between a pro and an amateur, when it gets down a couple seconds left, the amateur will take a Hail Mary shot. They can't score after they kill the dribble. The pros can.
Bryce can't get a shot off. Kempton pulling his way. Rebounded by Wolf of North Carolina.
Kempton put his shoulder down and just went right into his man. We're at a breakout point here. This is double digits. Digger, you got to get Barlow back in here because you need a shooter. He's your senior. I know he didn't take the shot from the key the last time he was in there, but you got to have him in at the end of the game here. You're going to get one last chance. They're probably popping up to 9-10 points now. Blue and gold get one last run at it. They've got to have their set starting 5 in there at that time.
Well, Jim Dolan has come on replacing Tim Kempton. 1-1 now with Doherty going to the line. Notre Dame over the limit. Only 5 points thus far for Brad Doherty.
Okay, Price, you're ready to take an outside shot against this, well, man-to-man.
That is rejected by Martin.
Oh, that'll make you think. Out to Price again.
Rivers from deep.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
And it's down to 6, 61-55.
We're under 4 minutes. Oh, there goes a guy to the floor. Royal just put Martin to the floor.
Yes. And he's hurt.
Royal 6'7" is stronger than I thought. Boy, that was it's going to be the best out of 3 here.
Looked like he took a shot on the cheek. Warren Martin shaking up.
Looked like the bridge hit him.
And Joe Wolf. Great places, Warren Martin.
Here's the move I was talking about. Barlow's back. If Notre Dame's going to grab Carolina at the wire, Barlow has to make a 2-3 outside shot. All right, again, Dean is starting to eat the clock at Melton. Melton eat the clock. Under a normal situation, this game would be over. It wasn't a 45-second clock. Dean to go to 4 corners. Notre Dame does not have the mobility. They take Dolan and Barlow and go back door on it. So look at them, they start kicking him right about now.
45-second clock down to 10. And we're down to 3 minutes and 10 seconds left in the game. Steve Hill.
No pass. Pass is good. Good pass.
And a foul against North Carolina. It's called on Hale, so he is fouled. the basket counts.
All right, it's no 1-1 now. They're still one away from the 1-1. North Carolina's in the 1-1. Next foul, Notre Dame's in it.
Steve Hale, 6 points on the day. Not looking for a shot today. He went 3-for-12 yesterday in the win over Georgia Tech.
Tough man to lose this time in the game. He got the maturity. He's a senior. He's been there before. Watch him penetrate high. Get the ball out of his hands before he commits the charge. If the ball was in his hands as he charged, the basket would not count.
And Warren Martin is back on the floor up front along with Dougherty and Wolf. North Carolina by 8. Under 3 minutes left in the game. Rivers can't find the shot. There's Price. Rivers on a crossover. Air ball. Marlow.
55! 55!
Boy, there is no way. There's no room under the basket.
Sardonic fashion of airball. Crowd waiting for that one.
Marlow being a senior. Put them on the line this time of the game. This is almost a must situation. They got to come up with a point or two this time down.
Marlow 89%.
Marlow gets 2 shots.
Shooter. Bucks over the foul limit. Marlow started on fire. Has 14 points. North Carolina taking charge.
Dean took Martin out because Martin is not a good ball handler. He put in an offensive team, wants to take about 30 seconds off the shot clock. This time down. Big foul.
6-point lead for number one ranked North Carolina. Looking to make it 21-0. Notre Dame comes in at 12-2. 21-0 would equal the best start of the coaching career of Dean Smith.
Now, you can't come out of them, Notre Dame. If you come out, they're going to end up getting a simple layup on you. Dean, I thought you started too late last time. You started about 10 seconds. I would start with about 15. There's 4 seconds left. 3, 2, 1. Start your movement. Come on, Jeff. Start your movement. No, see, they listen to the coach.
Right. Dean just pointed a finger.
Yeah, but it's a little bit too late. Creates the Hail Mary shot again.
Well, without a five on the shot clock, here's Smith. And Rivers comes away with it. Has a 3-on-2. That's a big turnover.
Here we go back to the same thing again. Dean will take a timeout. The problem that Dean's having is he's taking his ball players too close to the end of the shot clock, and amateurs can't handle it. They're putting up these Hail Mary shots.
Timeout with a minute 58 remaining of the game. We'll be right back. Marv Albert, Al McGuire from Chapel Hill. Al, we're about 10, 15 minutes away from an American celebration, the start of the Super Bowl festivities in New Orleans. What is the McGuire selection?
My daughter lives in Chicago, and I like Walter Payton so much that I take Chicago with a field goal at the gun.
And NBC would take that also.
Michael Weiss.
Yes, I can assure you. So Super Bowl 20 will get underway here on NBC. The pregame in about 10 minutes and kickoff time right around 5:15. But back here, in terms of basketball, North Carolina looking to make it a record of 21-0. The best start ever was back in 1924 when they won 26 without a defeat and were voted national champions. Right here, they have a 6-point lead with a minute and 45 left in the game.
Notre Dame cannot sit back anymore. You can't sit back. You're down 6. You got to come out. The game's over if you don't come out. You got to come out. The small clock is ticking away from them.
That's the 45-second clock on the right-hand portion of the screen.
We call that the small clock. The game clock is the big clock. Now watch the layup out of the penetrate. Get it back into Kenny Smith's hands. Kick it off to one of the forwards.
Up. Out of 5 on the shot clock. Here's Smith from the angle. And Dougherty keeps it alive.
That's why basketball belongs.
It's his first field goal the second half. An 8-point lead for North Carolina. And Digger Phelps called for timeout with a minute 4 remaining.
Digger, you can't be upset. The team has played magnificent present time.
And with the timeout, we'll take a break. We'll be back after this break. Great. Well, following today's game, North Carolina gets back to the ACC schedule. They'll take on Virginia at Charlottesville on Thursday, the next Saturday, back home for Clemson, while Notre Dame will be home for Utah on Wednesday, and the next Saturday, home for the Warriors of Marquette.
Well, what I think is happening with Dean Smith and booking these Saturday-Sunday games, I think in the back of his mind, he's trying to get ready for the NCAA, where you played a second game without much preparation. You only got about 30 hours for it. And this last 2 weekends have almost been a test run on the NCAA come up in March. Obviously, they'll be in the zone, force you to score from the outside.
See how they call it. It'll be Notre Dame ball with 56 seconds left in the game and an 8-point North Carolina lead.
North Carolina is one of the better foul shooting teams in the country.
Not able to hit. And we're down to 50 seconds left.
Smith and Lebo keep the ball in their hands because they're the best foul shooters. Did they call two shots or still one and one?
That's a one and one. Joe Wolf, a 68% free throw shooter, who is 2 for 2 from the line, will shoot one and one. He has 14 points. Kenny Smith with 16. Kent Barlow leads Notre Dame with 16. David Rivers with 14. So Wolf just adding to that Tar Heel lead.
He could give it a good run. Dean Smith, obviously, as I said yesterday, he's the boss. He's the Springsteen.
And a 10-point lead. It's the biggest lead of the day for North Carolina. A very convincing weekend for number one. Seconds left. Barlow rejected and a foul.
You know, it doesn't make any difference. It's academic, but that was no foul. Here he goes. You talk about a guy can burn. He smokes every time he breaks down court.
18 for Smith.
I think he's out of Archbishop Alloy. Jack Curran was his high school coach. Outstanding.
And there's the Dean, fourth winningest coach in the history of college basketball. He's had himself quite a weekend. A convincer yesterday over Georgia Tech. Notre Dame with a solid effort, but North Carolina will come away with the win to make it a record of 21-0.
Dean Smith has the whole laundry list from him. Brought the gold back to us in 76, the last true Olympics we had because of Russia. When we had the Olympics in Seoul in 88, it'll be the first time in 12 years that the United States will go against USSR.
69, 59. Out of 15 seconds, the chant of we're number one.
You know what? They're right.
To the fact that North Carolina is a solid number one. Michigan was upset yesterday by Michigan State. Scott Skiles of Michigan State with 41 points sitting on 15 of 20 from the field.
Mark, there's no upsets when you play the state rivals. When Michigan State goes against Michigan State, it's an alley time. He has one NCAA championship. Michael Jordan hit the shot down in New Orleans for Crescent City, where our guys are. Getting warmed up down there right now.
Warren Martin back, 15 seconds remaining. North Carolina by 12, 71-59. Here's Dolan. With a clock working down, 7 seconds left.
teams, obviously.
Notre Dame passed by Rivers. Notre Dame calls timeout.
And Notre Dame getting the timeout call with 4 seconds remaining.
He will not take the full 60 seconds. It'll take maybe 5-10 seconds. The coach is allowed to do that. The coach had called the timeout and limit the amount of time of the timeout.
Just for stopping that clock and a foul call. Out of 2 seconds.
I wonder if it stopped raining in New Orleans.
Well, are you concerned about the people walking around outside the Superdome, or?
I'm afraid with the weather, with the game.
I got it. A 10-point North Carolina lead, 2 seconds remaining, and Kenny Smith with 18 points, the high man, for the line once again. So you like the Bears by a field goal.
Yep.
Going for the dramatics.
Walter Payton is one of the
I'm talking about on the field. I'm talking about the first 20 points you can take in the sport. And that'll do it. North Carolina defeating Notre Dame by the score of 73-61. Kenny Smith, the high man, with 20. Joe Wolf at 16. Campardo led the Irish with 18. David Rivers with 15 points. North Carolina now 21-0. And Notre Dame with a record of 12-3. The executive producer of NBC Sports is Michael Weissman. The coordinating producer of NBC's basketball, George Finkel. Today's game produced by Kenneth Roy Edmondson. Directed by Harry Coyle. Our technical director, Jim Marshall. Thanks to our statistician, Ross Schneiderman. Marv Albert with Al McGuire from Chapel Hill. Super Sunday at American Celebration is just ahead. And that, of course, includes Super Bowl number 20 from the Super Bowl.